So I am honored to have Erick Schonfeld here. He runs the DEMO conference, which is always a great place to see new things. And there's a new one coming up this week, which might be last week by the time you see this, but you should check out the videos from the DEMO conference. And he also is doing a new video tool for iPad users called Touchcast. We're gonna see that as well. So Erick Schonfeld right now. And who are you?
Hey, I'm Erick Schonfeld, and I'm the executive producer of DEMO and co-founder of Touchcast.
Yeah.
And before that, I was the editor of TechCrunch and a technology journalist for about 20 years.
Yeah, you know what it means to feed the beast, then.
Yes, I do.
Which means put a lot of content out there. God, should we talk about DEMO first or Touchcast? Let's start with Touchcast.
Then okay, we'll yeah, let's DEMO. Start about Touchcast. We have it all set up here.
Yeah, and I'll get my GoPro so I can show what we're seeing here. What is Touchcast?
Well, Touchcast is a TV studio in your iPad, and we turn your iPad into a camera that has all sorts of different capabilities. So I have... here you see a video background, and if I was a subject here, you could see me there with the video background. I can add all sorts of effects. I can add whiteboarding capabilities, so I can draw on this. If this allows me to do it.
You're in. I think you had it in the.
I can effect. add titles, and then the magic is these VAPs or video apps. So I can add your website. I can add some icons here. I can add your, there's a GIF there, right? And if I was recording this, this would all be baked into the video.
Yep.
And then when you touch it, it opens up. So let's see what happens. So let's say I'm talking here. Hello, hey, check me out, I'm a cat.
Yep.
All right, and then we're done. And look, I can go to your website. I'm browsing the website while I'm watching the video. See that?
Oh, that's really cool.
And here's a GIF. I can activate the GIF. And then we have this whole notion of video apps or VAPs. So I can touch on this and it'll open up my my Twitter page. And we have about 20 different VAPs. Some of them open up within the context of the video itself, and sometimes open up a new browser window like this. So our whole idea is the video no longer has to be a self-contained view-only experience on a part of a web page. So this also works in our web player, and we want to take over the entire canvas of the web. So instead of it looking like a magazine layout, it can look like broadcast TV.
But so this brings your journalism skills, because a lot of people are going to CES or South by Southwest or whatever show, and they're or DEMO, and they're taking some video with an iPad on a little tripod, maybe with a microphone, mm-hmm. and okay, that gets you a certain amount of way, but like Rocky is running a TriCaster mm-hmm. here, and we have lower thirds, and we have
right.
the ability to do virtual studios, all sorts of crazy stuff that even Rocky doesn't even use, right? But when you're shooting on an iPad, you look sort of amateur hour at a certain level, and if you don't have lower thirds and you don't have this interactivity, and so your Touchcast lets you do that professionalism.
Yeah,
right, from an iPad, right?
Exactly. We want to bring the quality, the level of quality of video production up using democratized tools that is available to anyone. Yeah. We actually started with a big piece of equipment. That's a big piece of broadcast equipment that my co-founder Ido invented, which is the world's first transparent touchscreen for broadcast television. And that imagine the CNN touch wall, but instead of John King turning his back to the camera, it's transparent, and you have a Minority Report-like type of situation. We took that and we shrunk it into an iPad, and then we put it out to the world and democratize it.
Can I live video stream using your tool, or this is meant to record something and then put it out on your system or on YouTube?
Right. This is meant to, think of it as live to tape.
Yeah.
Right? So you record it And then when you're done, you publish it right onto Touchcast. So if I wanted to save this, I could. I'm not signed in, but whatever. I could publish it up to YouTube as a view-only mode. I could publish it to Touchcast.
Now, if it's Touchcast, you get all that interactivity where you can click on things in the video.
So Touchcast, this is just like Instagram, right? You can view as well, right? So there's a whole set of videos here that you can watch, and you can follow people, you can recast, right? Everything that you would expect from a regular, social media.
Yeah.
Right? But the thing is that this all becomes interactive. In this case, you gotta just wait for the...
So what do you mean by...
If you don't know how to make a latex bald cap, click on this link right here.
So if I click on that, that was just a hotspot. Of course, it's...
The supplies for this build all...
Got it. That interactivity improves engagement and also lets you monetize your videos because you can put links to buy this product or buy a ticket to demo or whatever you want to do to get people to convert on the videos.
So here's an example of something we're doing with Time Magazine.
Okay.
This is a little bit more professionally produced. And this is a travel video. So this becomes a navigational element. So see, now I'm getting information about all this stuff while I'm watching.
Though arts and music festivals seem to happen every day, the real heart of the art world in Santa Fe is Canyon Road. Stroll through the
And those, the way you did that interactivity is on these new video apps that your platform provides.
That's right. So you can
How many different video apps do you have?
We've got about 20 VAPs right now. We call them VAPs, short for video apps. And they include what you've been seeing here is mostly just web pages. So anything on the web you can put into the Touchcast, okay? But you can also add things like maps. You can add Twitter streams, Google News headlines.
Can I do something like a survey?
We have polls. We've got polls and questions. We have all of that. And if we don't have something, you can develop it yourself. It's an open platform. And if you know HTML, you can create your own VAPs that have your own, you can skin them the way you want, and you can have the functionality that you want. And we encourage developers out there to create whatever VAPs they want. They don't need any permission from us. There's a developer VAP. All you need to do is point to a server, and then pulls it in into the Touchcast as a VAP.
And how much do you, how do you monetize this?
So we monetize it right now with, when we work with enterprises, meaning media companies, essentially.
Yeah, like a Red Bull or something like that?
Large broadcast and other publications who license both our tools and our player.
Okay.
So it's like, think of us.
How much would you charge for a Rackspace? We have 6,000 employees. Do you charge by employees? How do you charge?
Think of it like Adobe Creative Cloud. So
I don't know what they charge.
They charge anywhere from $50 to $70 per seat.
Per seat. Okay.
Per month. And then on the player side, we charge for the player, and that depends on how big you are and what your volume of streams are and everything.
Okay. Cool. And you can certainly push it over to YouTube, which gets rid of some of the features, but then you get YouTube video for free. Right?
That's right, you get YouTube video for free. You can upload this to YouTube and it'll be view only mode. So many people like to use this just to create video, and then they use YouTube as a distribution, and we're very happy with that as well.
Very cool.
Yeah.
So that's Touchcast.
That's Touchcast.
And so that's your demo, which
that's
is usually
demo.
Your the other way, right? You're usually asking people to demo to you on stage, right?
Yeah, that wasn't a very good demo, I'm afraid. But I've been focused on demo, which is this week here in San Francisco, and it's Demo Enterprise. So I took over demo about a year ago, and sort of switching gears a little bit. This April 3rd in San Francisco, we're going to do Demo Enterprise, and it's all products and startups that are launching as long as the end customer is a business. And we have an amazing group of about two dozen companies.
This video is going to go up probably after Thursday. Can you give me a taste of some of the companies that would have been up? And do you share all the videos from Demo?
Yeah, all the videos are available on demo.com and on YouTube, and you'll see, you know, the you'll see who the Demo gods were. But you know, in essence, I'll say that there's some really interesting 3D printing companies. There's some interesting wearables, industrial wearables. Oh. There's some, of course, cloud and mobile, as you would expect. And then there's a whole sort of session that sort of became this DevOps session, which is, you know, it's sort of a real up and coming hot area. It used to be that, you know, the IT department used to be these maintainers of systems. Yeah. And now they have to be more nimble, and they actually have to, build products internally in these big enterprises, and it's changing the way that computing is happening. And we have a great list of speakers. Alan Kay is going to be speaking. Wow. We've got
and that'll be up on YouTube.
Yeah, that'll be up on YouTube. We have Keith Rabois and Barry Silbert having a discussion about Bitcoin, what it's going to take for that to become real money. Helen Greiner from iRobot, who now is doing a drone company, is going to do a talk about industrial drones and why now is the time for drones. We are going to have...
What is an industrial drone? That's interesting.
Well, it's not a hobbyist drone, and it's not a military drone. It's what are the industrial applications for drones, whether it's everything from surveillance, asset tracking to delivery, right, which is what Amazon wants to do.
Well, yeah.
Well, maybe, right?
I think that's PR, but...
Yeah, and then Aaron Levy is going to be speaking in...
Box.net.
Yeah, they just filed for an IPO, so that should be interesting. Yeah. Howard Lerman from Yext, it's going
to
be great.
That's interesting, because is he going to be able to talk about anything, because he's in quiet period? A lot of times those speakers all of a sudden disappear. You
know? Yeah, well, I was worried a little bit about that, but he assured me on Friday that he was going to come, and there's some things he can talk about, some things that he can't. But, I really tried to focus Demo on kind of founders, and he definitely has a lot of great stories about building a company, and that's fair game.
When I first met him, I thought, this guy's going to get fired. And how wrong I was.
Good thing he was the boss, right?
No, you know, when you take investor money, you're never the boss.
That's right.
Somebody else is in charge of your life at some level. But out to be one of the best entrepreneurs I've ever met. And man, that first impression just was like, man, this guy's a goofball. He's going to get fired.
I remember him sneaking into a TechCrunch party and let him in. And he was pitching me because he wanted to write guest posts. And I was like, okay, just send me a guest post. And he turned out to be one of our best guest writers. He's a really great writer.
Yeah.
And he's also great on Twitter as well.
Yeah.
So I'm really looking forward to that.
He's one of my favorites on Twitter. And I've had the chance to interview him a couple times. Really, really smart guy. And really energetic. In fact, that was one of the questions I asked, is how does your team control you? Because you can walk in a meeting and just change the course of the meeting, and that might not always be a good thing.
Right? Yeah.
And he actually had a good answer to that.
So you know, I mean, there's like, you were just saying before that there's like a million conferences now, and there's certainly a lot of places to launch. I've been trying to rethink Demo a little bit along the lines of, well, first, you know, just have the quality of companies that are launching there be the best possible, so that it's really a badge of honor to launch a Demo. It's the best of the best. But then additionally, I think it's a place where, you know, people can come and get a glimpse of the future a little bit. And also, I've been focusing on, you know, companies that are really focused on big problems. That's my cut. Like, are you really solving a hard problem? And I think a lot of people are hungry for that.
Yeah, well, I'll be there.
Okay.
Where do we learn more about Demo? And this isn't the last Demo. There's demos every few months, right?
Well, we have two a year. So the next one will be in November in San Jose. We're going to be in the new San Jose Convention Center. And it'll be 3 days. And that'll be everything, enterprise and consumer. So if you're a startup founder that has a company that is going to launch an
awesome
product.
What are the dates for that?
November 15th, I think.
Okay.
I've got a... Remember.
Yeah, I got to put that on my calendar because so many people are already booking me.
Yeah, mid to late November, we got to get you there.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely.
Right after Web Summit in Dublin, Ireland.
That's right.
Hey. My favorite pub crawl. demo.com, touchcast.com, right? And anything else that we need to know?
No, just download, you know, if you have an iPad, download Touchcast. And
is it free to try?
It's absolutely free to consumers right now. You get all of the features that that large media companies get. And our bet is that you know, we don't know whether it's going to be the large broadcasters and publishers of the world, or it's going to be, you know, some unknown
Wayne's World
kind. Yeah, Wayne's World person or teenager, you know, just creating amazing Touchcast. And we want it to become kind of a new standard, because when you bring these two mediums together, video and the web, we think that new types of video are going to be created.
The reason I like iPad, one, you can see the video, where if you're shooting on an iPhone or a Samsung phone or something like that, it's hard, sometimes hard to see, did you get the focus right?
And, right.
And are you able to position these things everywhere? But my iPad is always connected, so I can upload right from there very, very quickly and get something out on Feed the Beast, as I started out with. Right, and get a piece of video up on Facebook or
yeah,
YouTube.
We were at South by Southwest. Yeah. We were at Capital Factory, set up a Capital Factory, and we were just doing little quick videos of asking people this question: what's the hardest problem you want to solve? And we did me and one other person. We did 30 videos, and we just as soon as they were done, we just uploaded them. And meanwhile, there were other video crews at Capital Factory and all around South by Southwest, and I was still seeing their videos, you know, 2 weeks later.
Yep.
When it was too late.
Yep.
And that's a problem in a news type of situation. You want to get it up there and get it up there quickly.
Yep.
But you don't want just to put up an iPhone video, because that looks like crap, right? So you want to...
You can shoot on Touchcast and then add in the video apps later, right?
Exactly. We have this video import feature where you can either shoot and then add the layers afterwards, and all the graphics, telestration, whiteboarding, you know, it's not just the video apps. It's a full suite of effects, visual effects, filters, sound effects. You can bring in a background audio bed.
Yeah.
We just added that in our latest release.
So you can add some music in.
You can add some music in. So it's getting to be pretty fully featured. You know, we also have a PC version, so if you want to just shoot like you do here, have super beautiful video and then import it and then add the VAPs later, you can do that as well. And we do both, but more and more I'm leaning on the iPad, because it's just the curve is just going through the roof and it's just catching up, and the gap between the two is going away. It's just incredible that you can do chroma key on this, and you can do background removal.
Yeah, we don't have a green screen, so yeah. It doesn't really work on our screen. But yeah, if you had a green background, you can chroma key that, or replace the green with like a picture of Yosemite or something like that, right?
Right. So I mean, it works a little bit. There you go.
Yeah.
See, there's a little video.
Yeah. So yeah, you can sort of see it. You're trying to chroma key in on our white wall here.
Yeah. There you go.
Cool. Thank you very much for coming in.
And, thanks for having me.
Thanks for what you're doing for startups, because it's always a privilege to go and see what's coming out at Demo Conference.
Yeah, thanks.